Call us on your cell phone.
Culinary hotline bling.
That can only mean one thing.
Well, it's Friday and that can only mean one thing. It's time for the culinary hotline bling. Ting, ting, ting. Today we're taking a trip to our favorite winter veggie patch. Now we know that winter is the best excuse for all those naughty comfort foods, but it's also the worst time to get the colds and to get the flus. And as South Africans, though, this poses a bit of a problem and a little bit of a challenge because of one thing, the braai. Because let's face it, not a lot keeps us away from lighting up our braai fires, especially with the rugby this weekend. But the good news is that you can still get all those good nutrients in that you need. And of course, here to tell us more about putting together the best, healthiest dishes around the braai is Hylian Meyer and of course, Annel Potgieter. Make some noise for our beautiful Bok ladies representing.
Thank you.
And so good to have you in the show.
Yes, always great to be here.
Representing all the way. And of course, Annel, you know, I love you, girl.
I love you too.
Okay, so we've got this beautiful array of vegetables here, which just makes me so happy. But which one are we going to start off with first? Because maybe we should start off with my favorite, pumpkin.
Always good. And
it's one of nuts.
You can use either. This is one of my favorite dishes.
Yeah.
And it's very basic and simple. And to me, the beauty of a dish like this is the fact that you have got elements that complement one another.
I love it.
And everybody enjoys it. Even those that say, I don't do salad, end up dishing a second time.
But so, you know, the nice thing about this salad is it's got such a heartiness to it. You feel almost like a meaty texture sometimes when you're eating it together. And it's filling too.
Yes, definitely. Because you've got butternut and cauliflower and chickpeas. Ooh. And we're going to add some lovely creamy avocado. Lemons. Thanks for slicing that so long. And this was literally just roasted in the oven. And the beauty of this dish is you can have it straight from the oven or at room temperature.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you need to have your side dishes ready tomorrow morning before you watch the game, you can prepare this tonight or tomorrow morning early, and it can just mingle in the flavors until you're ready to serve it, and then some fresh herbs with it.
Yeah, what I like about that is that we use cauliflower.
I love cauliflower too.
It's taken
a whole new life for me because it's so versatile.
And it's low in calories, high in fiber, and 1 cup of cauliflower, it's got 5 grams of carbs.
Yeah.
While rice, a cup of rice, has got 45 grams of... So it's 9 times more carbs than rice.
Yes, but you can also make cauli rice.
I know. Definitely.
Yes. That's a nice thing. You can make a delicious puree. Yeah. You can roast it and caramelize it.
Yeah, I mean, just look at this color and that nuttiness that comes from the cauliflower. It's way better than any overcooked head of cauliflower smothered in cheese sauce. So this is really an easy, straightforward, delicious combination.
So that is just roasted. What I like about this, you have rooibos tea. You've got rooibos tea on it. That's very interesting.
Often people would use stock to get some moisture into a dish.
Yeah.
But I've mixed the oil and the seasonings with a strong rooibos tea.
Oh, why?
And then you toss the vegetables in it. It gives the vegetables moisture.
Okay.
But if you roast them in a single layer like this, you don't want them to dry out before they're cooked.
Yeah.
So the rooibos tea helps to keep them moist. And obviously rooibos tea is very healthy.
Yeah.
So you do get those benefits included. So there's nothing... What shall I say? Wrong about this dish.
Yeah.
Everything is healthy.
You are such a health freak, Killian.
Yeah, but it's so lekker.
Yeah, yeah.
If it's lekker, then it's... And it's healthy, then it's a double bargain.
And Leanne, I just want to say... against contrary belief, my mother always said that pumpkin is going to make my cheeks go red and going to make the hair curly, but it's not true.
Didn't it happen? Red cheeks and curly hair. It didn't happen. Oh, Mom, but at least you got you to eat your veggies. You got to do whatever you can. All right, so this is a possibility for anyone who's going to, or everyone who's going to be watching the game between South Africa and New Zealand on Saturday. How many people does a salad like this feed? That's what I always want to know.
If this is a side dish, then I would say 4 to 6 portions, depending on the other elements on your table.
Yep.
But if you are serving this as a vegetarian meal, I would say about 3 portions.
Wonderful.
Because then that would be... And as we discussed earlier,
yeah.
if you don't want to use... the feta, it could also be a vegan meal.
Okay,
yeah.
I see
so
what you mean.
You
so there's a
really
little bit of everything in there for anyone. If you would like our delicious roast butternut and cauliflower salad, and there's some chickpeas in there and some avo and all the good things, all you have to do is SMS the keyword roast to 33728. We'll gladly send you the ingredients list and the link to the recipe, and you could be making this yourself.
Another thing about the butternut, 3 tablespoons of butternut.
Yeah.
Equal is one vegetable of your 5 veggies a day. So we need to get in 5 veggies. So if you get like 3 tablespoons in, count as one. So Daya said it,
And I always say, if you eat with your eyes first and you think, this looks good, then it will be good.
And this is definitely
Does this need a dressing or not?
No, because the everything else is quite moist and the avocado gives you that sense of creaminess. I never, if you want to, if you did roast it a little bit longer and you want to drizzle a glug of olive oil over this or avocado oil, that would be delicious.
Do you know
what I love? Or just a squirt of lemon juice would be fantastic over this.
I love the fact that the salad has everything. It's got the creaminess of the avo, it's got texture because we've also got the chickpeas
roasted
in
chickpeas.
There. Oh, it's
just
good.
Yeah, they're nice and crispy. So they are like little nibbles of goodness.
You didn't need to put any salt in it because I taste that the feta actually is enough to give the salt.
You see there? I love it. Roast to 33728. We'll gladly send you the link to the recipe and the ingredients list, and you could be making this delicious roast cauliflower and butternut salad, perfect as a side or as a main dish. It's my feel-good
breakfast show. Call us on your cell phone.
Culinary Hotline Bling.
That can only
Welcome
mean
back
one
to your
thing.
Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. And we're back with the Culinary Hotline Bling. Ting, ting, ting. The Friday edition. And of course, Friday is Friday as we get ready for hopefully a smashing weekend where we will smash New Zealand and show them who's boss when it comes to that blockbuster of a rugby match. But we also asked you, when it comes to Friday, what are the sides that you enjoy? And Josephine Pickstone actually responded. She said, my favorite side dish with my braai is pasta salad, but differently with delicious ingredients. I love that. Yes. Also, another one coming through from Nicole Grimani, who says, pasta salad, slaws, and potato salad. Love trying different ingredients. We love that because it's all about our winter veggies. But earlier on, we made a delicious cauliflower and butternut salad. And our experts in the kitchen, Hillian Mayer, and our very own and now Port Hitted. And today we're using a different veggie for this segment. We're using cabbage.
Cabbage,
which I'm not gonna lie, most people are not necessarily fans of cabbage. A few weeks ago, and now you made us sauerkraut.
Yes.
Very interesting.
Have you tasted that?
I did. And I loved it. But but you know what? What are you gonna do with cabbage today that's gonna take it to a whole nother level? Because I see orange segments, I see kumkumir.
And dill.
And dill.
Yeah.
Do you know dill?
I know dill. I know dill. All right, so what are we going to be using today with our cabbage?
I've made a dressing here with apple cider vinegar, a little bit of honey and oil, olive oil. Or avocado oil, whatever you prefer, with fresh dill. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be used to marinate the cabbage and the cucumber a little bit.
Okay.
Almost like a fresh pickle, but it literally just marinates for 15 minutes.
All right.
So that gives it a lovely sort of extra flavor, and the crunchiness of the cabbage is softened slightly, but without it going pop.
Yeah.
There isn't an English word for pop.
No, we don't want it to go pop.
But it doesn't say the same.
Pop is so much
We don't want it pop.
And then we found out that cabbage belongs to the group of coal crops, which means that it's closely related to broccoli, cauliflower, and Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, there's a hele cool family daar buitekant. Niggies, neefies. Ons het broccoli, ons het bok choy, ons het Chinese cabbage, ons het enige, daar's so baie in die cool family. And they're all really low in calories.
Yes.
And rich in fiber.
Yes.
A perfect, perfect thing to eat.
Beautiful.
And then the combination of the cucumber and cabbage with citrus.
Smells nice.
And it's all seasonal.
It is,
so you can make your own combination of grapefruit, oranges, whatever you like.
Oops.
And and to get the segments to look pretty, you literally take the top and the bottom off the lemon. Ach, the lemon, the orange.
Yeah.
And then, lemon and sir lemon. From the orange, and then you just cut the skin away without losing too much of the flesh.
Yeah.
And what I like to do is then cut in between the membranes to remove the individual segments. But I do that over a bowl so that you catch all the orange juice and you make that part of your dressing.
Because the membrane is also quite sour as well, so you want it to just be sweet.
Yeah, and some people don't like that. They don't. They always remove that from the orange.
This is like really chefy, Ilian.
It is very chefy.
Very chefy.
It's so easy.
And show us. I can never do this right. Vice for my
Okay. Then And it's important to work over a bowl because it does become quite a dripping business.
And that you can use in your salad dressing, those drippings.
Yeah, yes. So all the last little bits, so you just keep going like that. And then right at the end, you literally squeeze all the last juice from the core of the orange.
Wow, fantastic.
And then you end up with beautiful little wedges, but you didn't waste any of the orange.
So what is the salad's name now?
It is cabbage and cauliflower citrus salad.
Ooh. Cabbage and cauliflower citrus.
Not cauliflower, cucumber. Oh, yes, I'm so concentrated.
Cabbage and cucumber citrus salad. And if you would like this salad, its recipe, and of course the ingredients that went into it, all you have to do is SMS the keyword salad to 33728. We will gladly send you the recipe and the ingredients list, and you could be making this yourself. It's all about sides for the braai, or this could be a main meal in itself. But let me tell you, it looks absolutely amazing. I think that this is actually all that you need.
I think the citrus works very well with the cucumber.
Yeah. And it's going to... it's so fresh. It's alive. It's delicious. It's fragrant. I love it. Fragrant, not flagrant.
And dill is a perfect little herb to go with it.
Yes.
Because dill complements both cabbage, cucumber and citrus, all the C's.
We love it. Okay, so we've got two more social comments coming through as well. Chitty Rose says, grated carrots and cabbage with onions and mayo, baked beans with sliced mushrooms, potato salad with diced boiled eggs and mayo. However, I'd like something different. Wow, that sounds like a lot.
It's a mouthful.
Where do you start? Also, Shireen Abrams says, good morning, Anel, and Helian, and Leanne. Hi, you are looking stunning. I always make salads on sunny days with my braai. Can you ladies suggest some other side dishes? I'm watching you right now. Have a lovely day and a super weekend. Hi, Shireen.
Hello.
Thank you so much for that.
I've got a lovely idea with cauliflower. So you take the whole head of cauliflower and you cut it into steaks, like real big slices.
Yeah.
Then you just take a bit of olive oil with a bit of smoked paprika, perhaps, a bit of garlic, and you brush it over it and you braai it.
Okay.
On the braai and grill it.
Oh, that's a side in itself.
That's a side in itself.
And that flavor from a roasted cauliflower.
Oh, it is. Heerlijk.
But ek is baie lief vir aardappelslaai met mayonnaise en eiers.
Well, thank you so much, Helian. Thank you so much, Anel.
It's a pleasure.
Hopefully these are the new sides that you're going to try around the braai as we cheer South Africa on Saturday. It is Bok Friday and we are enjoying every second.
Go Bokka!